but Fredo. There's a difference between being a Fredo and then being a Fredo.
I know. This it's all is, in where you put the emphasis.
This is Flash, somebody, and...
GramZ, Mary.
In a perfect world, tonight on this Tuesday, the fourth day of February, 2020. Do the usual stuff with me tonight, Miss Mary?
I certainly will. And I do have to say, I totally did not know until my brother called me Sunday morning to discuss mom stuff. I didn't know that it was Super Bowl Sunday. And needless to say, we did not watch. I hear the chefs won. Yay. But I had to put that out there that I had no freaking clue it was Super Bowl Sunday. Yeah. And I totally spazzed off Groundhog Day.
Wow.
Both of them.
You know, you could be risking your fishing license.
I could be.
Read the paperwork. I'm just guessing, but I would say there's something in there about if you don't watch the Super Bowl, it's an extra 37% on your fishing license.
And then, seeing as how the Super Bowl was on Groundhog Day, and you totally spazzed that off as well. Yeah, I know. It's like I am in so much deep duty. I keep telling people, please, ground me to my room. And now that it's rearranged and all feng shui,
yeah,
ground me to my room so I can lay down and rest.
Wow. I thought I had it wrote. Apparently not, but let's say hey to the Grimnir first off. Hey Grim!
Hey! In the RLM chat right up top, we got Barman, the most splendiferous bot in the whole wide world. And Barman just let everybody know that In a Perfect World is on right now. I also see Beetle! Hey, Beetle! What you up to, dude? Where's Pepe?
Hey, Beetle,
I also see Grimner is here, the RLM god,
Grimner.
Don't you know? And by the way, Grim, I did get your message, and you are most welcome, kind sir. The lovely Miss Moose Goyle is also here. Moosey! Oh, looks like the farmer's going to let the doggies in.
Uh-oh.
This should be interesting.
Hell hath no fury, lad.
Very like
dogs.
A slinky dog. I also see the lovely Miss Kate is here. Hey,
Miss
Kate,
Kate,
how you doing? Oh, look, Rob Works fired up the bubbler.
Hey,
Booyah!
Rob Works the bubbler.
Yeah, we got an anti in the chat,
hey,
as
anti.
Well as Asmodeus Asmo.
Asmodeus.
Asmodeus. We also got a Chalcedony in the chat.
Well, she's upstairs, and her computer's hooked up, but I think she's upstairs getting a night time. Yeah, she's got to work in the city tomorrow.
Well, darn it all.
I know.
Did you guys
puts
get
her
snow?
To bed early. Nope, not a fucking half inch of snow so far, thank you. But today, it was colder than a giraffe's butthole. I'm telling you. But no snow. But we get a wind that'll just like, oh, it's the kind of wind that just slap you in your nipples and wake you right up.
Oh, I know. We got one of them going on right now out of the north.
Aren't they wonderful?
So every time I open the door to let the doggies in or let the doggies out, it also takes me out because it just grabs
oh, yeah.
In.
Yeah.
Whee! Yeah. We got an echelon in the chat
echelon
as well.
In the chat.
And there's Flash somebody.
Hello,
there.
Me.
Frumpy's here as
hey,
well as
Frumpy
upstairs.
Yeah, I saw that this morning. He came on with that.
He's upstairs. Wonder what he's doing. I don't want to know.
Yeah, you do.
I don't want to know.
We're going to spend a half hour trying to figure it out.
Probably. I'm here.
GramZ. I know. More or less.
Jabba Dr. Two is in the house, as well as Meister
Woody.
Brar. Woody. And we got some prints going on in here as well. And Rob Wikes, once again, thank you once again for firing up the bubbler. I will partake cybernetically. Thank you very much. I know. Okay, I got old. I trust no one.
Hey, trust no one. She's making fun of me now. Damn it.
We also got Vanna White, the letter turner of the RLM channel.
Yeah.
How cold is a giraffe's butthole? Well, it's pretty cold when the south end of a giraffe is facing north, and it's got its mouth open. It's got a hell of a breeze through.
Well, let's just say that a giraffe's butthole is so cold that you would seek heat from it under these weather conditions. How's that for a good one, huh?
Well, you know, I had that discussion with my mom yesterday because she said it's colder than hell out there. And I said, how do you know, Mom? I've had things that were so cold they burned me. So maybe hell is so cold that it's burning cold.
Ooh, that would be a good topic later tonight, too.
Yes, it would.
Oh, I got a good one to start out with, though. Oh, you got to finish the haze.
Yeah, I got to finish the haze and highs and hoes.
Crazy, man.
Trust me, no one.
Nah, no one. No,
yeah,
wow.
I already did that. And Vanna. So, Weather Dork. I have a question for you, Weather Dork. Why did you make it 82 degrees on Sunday? Although I'm not really complaining about that because it was really nice driving home weather. But why was it 82 degrees on Sunday and then frickin' burr yesterday and today? What the hell?
Chemtrails.
Oh, chemtrails. Okay.
Yeah, I would say that that's the one of the byproducts of you spraying us with these chemicals. Abrupt weather changes.
I think it was the Phantom.
Okay.
And the Phantom is next anyway, so I think it was the Phantom.
Not the Phantom. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Phantom. It wasn't chemtrails. It was the Phantom.
The Phantom.
Mary has spoken. There you go.
That's right. We got a
CC66.
As well as a Tuscura.
Tuscura.
And a cyborgian noodle. You'd be by that cyborgian noodliness.
No.
And She-Ra. I saw Circle did not wish to be empowered. Last time I got empowered like that,
well,
I spun in circles saying, no, I have the power
hold
and
on.
I fell down.
Hold on. Let me try to make this simple for that. The idea that she would ever think of it is absurd to her. There is no empowering her because she's female. There's stupid.
Well, yeah.
There you go. So the idea of all this, it just makes her laugh.
I think instead of being called females, we should be called fee-fi-fo-fum males.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, make
you know,
the name
mama
longer.
Ain't happy, ain't nobody happy.
Nah, I don't know. That's a lot of syllables, lady. I don't know if I could do that. I'm having trouble with hey, miss. I don't know.
It'd be the end of civilization, just like NCIV. We also got a Frumpy Woik in the chat.
Frumpy Woik. Wow, triple player.
And thanks for having that burn into my retinas, Frumpy Woik. I clicked on that Twitter link while Flasher was straightening me out. I also see a grommet.
Sucker.
I know. As well as JJ's.
JJ's.
I hope it's not windy there. And, oh, nuts for art.
I thought it said nuts for Jews. Oh, okay. Nuts for art.
No,
who's
it's,
art?
It's
I don't see any art in
for
here.
Art.
That's
yeah,
Lonnie
well,
Clark.
You know.
She's not in here. She would never believe or listen to two words that I got to say.
Now, okay.
I've listened to her show. I mean,
wow. Okay.
You probably agree with her side, too, the things that she talks about. It's a good show. I'm not complaining about the show. I'm just saying I hold a different opinion, and people call me names because I'm strange.
I've listened to part of her show once, and I just haven't been around to watch or listen anymore because that one was like, oh, shit, I got to go. So, in any case, Papa Papa Pond Sauce is also here as well as Sock Puppet.
Sock Puppet!
And we got a Slim Jim Flynn in the chat and a Smotaz.
The Smotaz
always given the Trumples shit. I know. Miss Van Meter, that damn Van Meter just popped in.
Hey, Donna, what's up?
That wild woman.
No. Nah, she's not wild.
The holiest Roger ever.
Yeah.
And
what do you do with your holes there, Roger?
Ew. Start calling him Swiss cheese. And to round out the crew, the one, the only, the Z-Pix.
Z-Pix was playing Chatterbox with me on the Real Liberty Media today, and I had a giggle about it. I like people with a sense of humor that don't, you know, have ignorant perspectives about life. So, welcome to this insane asylum, there's Z-Pix, if you're listening tonight. Well, not a lot of people enjoy typing with me, Mary.
Well, that's because you have obnoxious typey fingers.
Yeah, I like to go on and on, too. I beat the dead horse until it is bloody raw all over your feet.
You beat the dead horse until there's not even bone powder left, don't you?
I've been accused of worse. I blame it on the Jew blood. You know, that Jew blood in me just goes, fuck you, Goyams. I show you. Want to see my circumcision? Here's my nose. My superpowers have been engaged. Super Jew. So ridiculous. Anyway, welcome to In a Perfect World tonight with me and my co-hostage, GramZ from RealLibertyMedia.com. And tonight, I call tonight's show, Does Television Make You Stupid? Now, what I'll do is I'll post the link into the RealLibertyMedia.com chat for your reading approval. And here we go. Click.
Sweet.
Now, you want to do some reading, or I haven't heard your lovely voice for a while, so I've been doing radio alone. And then Rob Works came and visited the Dork Table Saturday, but I've been alone. So
he rescued you from your lonely Jewiness, huh?
I don't know. I'm just not cut out to, you know, to be alone too much. I get into trouble.
Well, you make weird noises when you fly solo.
Yeah, that too. But anyway, would you like to indulge us with a little bit of this next story that I thought of putting in the show?
It looks like it's from, is that from Akshmeed?
I don't know how to read
that.
Something
like that.
Yeah, Akshmeed. I don't know. Well, Akshmeed. See, if it was in Danish, the D is silent in some words. Because, you know, every language has its little fucked up rules. I'll tell you about what well and how I got introduced to the Danish word well, or not well, what. Sorry, I got distracted by a squirrel there for a minute. But first, let's hear Miss Mary.
So does television make you stupid? Apparently that's what science says because, well, science! So, the answer to the question, does television make you stupid, seems official. The research results of several studies show how regular TV consumption makes us unable to question our surroundings and pose problems for ourselves. Reason enough to finally switch off, which it's not just television consumption. That's just part of the whole 1, 2, 3. Because, you know, they start with the neurotoxins at a very young age and then turn on the television to engage the neurotoxins that were. So, yeah. And then now they've got 5G, but I digress. So the average man spends a full 3 hours in front of the TV every day. Wow. You know, I can sit in front of a TV without having it on. Do you know I could do that?
I do.
I do it a lot.
Oh, I know that, but I know you can. But you know what my superpower is?
What's that?
Is it can be on and I kind of ignore it. You know, like I'm following a story, but I'm not glued sitting there in one spot staring at the TV. I'll be doing something else to keep my hands busy, but the movie will be playing. But very rarely do I sit and get into that mind. And the reason I agree with that, when I went to the grocery tonight, as I'm walking down the street, the people with big TVs on the street, they have their windows open so everybody knows they got a big, gigantic TV.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Well, it's what the content on the TV is that gets my attention. And one of my neighbors has they got a basically newborn couple, 5-6 month old baby, give or take. I'm not sure, but at the months, but from looking in. And the guy is sitting there entertaining his son, child, whatever, but that TV's on the news. Right. So I'm watching the guy and, you know, and I know from what I know about all this stuff now that his attempt at what he thinks he's doing and the results are two different things. Okay.
Yeah.
That was all I wanted to interrupt for.
Oh, okay.
But you got it, right? You understood what I mean. I think it comes with experience and age with these particulars. You know?
Yeah.
You can't make this judgment without experience, and you can't get the experience without fucking up.
Yeah.
It's priceless.
Yeah. It's one of those wonderful little circular things. What goes around comes around. First you have to do the stupid shit, and then you have to figure out why you shouldn't do the stupid shit anymore.
Yeah, exactly. Okay.
Okay. So, basically it says that that extrapolates out to 8 to 10 years of our lives, which that's if you do the 3 hours in front of the TV every
day. Right. So that would be some kind of average that would probably come out with, too.
Yeah.
So the numbers are still skewed, no matter how they report it to us. They're making estimates based on questions that they're asking people. There's no real physical proof to any of this. It's all they think.
Well, and it's all based on a question that they ask, and then they gather all of the information, and then they decide which information they want to use because it supports whatever preconceived notion they had going into asking the question in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
So it's called selective editing with the data.
Yeah, because I would say the average person would disclude somebody that was homeless. They wouldn't be considered an average person. They would be considered, no, they are the scum of the world. They have no money. Boo, boo, boo. So,
yeah,
well, that's how we're trained to judge each other, by our possessions.
True.
Big mistake.
Mm-hmm. It goes on to say the production companies have long understood that in order to sell advertising space, they simply have to create a program that is easily digestible, that absolutely everyone can follow it. Advertising. So, there we find naked singles who are looking for the dream partner on a lonely island. Yeah, you know, I don't have that kind of shit going on my TV. And news in which the events of the day are wrapped and so-called knowledge programs that explain to us that the longest bratwurst in the world was prepared at the weekend. Wow, longest bratwurst. Wow.
Exactly. That's the point. More useless shit. You don't need to know. That's what trivia is for.
Well, I do enjoy trivia just because every once in a while it's fun to throw that crap out there and people look at you like, where the hell did that come from?
And have you ever sat down and considered how much of that shit, somebody usually answers it. They got to ask some obscure questions not to get something, right? So how many hours that this group of trivia players has spent wasting our time listening to the answers to these pointless questions? That's why they call it trivia, because it doesn't have a purpose. It's just something to do.
It's trivial in nature. Yes.
Right. Okay, but see, it keeps you away from physically doing something of any value.
Ah, but sometimes sitting around and playing a game of trivia helps your mind to get away from some of the other things that it's been obsessing over. And so, okay, I'm going to focus on some trivial nonsense for a while. And then whatever pops up will go, oh, hey, that's just exactly what I was looking for. Okay, I'm out of here. So that's okay. That's the way my mind works.
That's why you're on the show. That's why you're here and other people are not here. You have the ability to voice an opinion based on your experience or say, I don't know, and not just, you know, tell me I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, well, I don't want to talk about it.
Too late. I already told you that one.
Okay.
Where are we?
Well, this goes on to say, but although everyone is talking diligently about the excesses of the German television landscape, I have not said a frickin' word until now about the German television landscape. I digress. It does seem that normal consumers have long lost the struggle for self-control. Okay. That's pretty obvious when you walk into the grocery store and you got someone in there that's either got very few teeth
Well, you got to read the
really, really large.
You got to read the
and
quote,
they're
Mary.
Going straight for the snack
Mary,
aisle.
Mary, you got to read what? The quote above what the end of that was.
I know. Television That's helps the stupid to remain stupid.
By Earnhard Horst Bellarmine. So that's not, I don't think he's an American. I don't even think he's an Italian. I think he's a German.
I think he might be them one of them der Germans. One of them der.
There you go. But that's why it led into out of nowhere, why it was written that way. And you left the reader, the listener, out of the loop there, Miss Mary.
Yeah, but they can read along.
If
yeah,
they
but,
got it.
Yeah,
well,
but I yeah. am exercising my yeah, but right here. Yeah, but.
You're so funny.
So, does television make you stupid?
Yeah.
Apparently, yeah. Several studies, most recently by the Lower Saxony Criminological Research Institute, with 23,000 children and adolescents, show that what may have already secretly been known, the intelligence quotient is apparently inversely proportional to the person's television consumption. Ugh. That means that the more someone watches TV, the more stupid they appear to be or to become.
Okay.
Now,
that could be a coincidence, too.
They appear.
Right.
And number two, they're doing children and adolescents. Okay, how many children and adolescents to your average adult will seem anything other than stupid or lose not having any self-control? Or, I mean, that they, yeah, that's skewing the research right there.
What?
Just using kids. Use adults.
Is it?
Look at how many adults are out there. And I tell you what, that word adult, A-D-U-L-T,
yeah.
is morphing into adult,
A-D-O-L-T. Wow. Boy,
Vanna, I would like an O instead of a U. Because, yeah, there's an awful lot of adults that are adult.
Yeah, but, you know, they're just trying to back up that side of the argument. So,
I know. So they ask the question in such a way that and
either,
gather the data in such a way that it reinforces the proposed idea they wanted to put forth, which I do argue with their initial concept. Yes, it does make you stupid.
Well,
but,
in your opinion, right? Or I'm lost on where you
it's
stand
like
on it.
Grimmy said in the chat.
Mm-hmm.
But television makes me stupid. I saw it on TV. And there are an awful lot of people. It's either I saw it on TV or it was on the internet. So
yeah,
it must be true.
Yeah. Well, I think that in a sense, we all belong to the same, in that same group. Because most of the things that I find that are what I believe to be true are available on the internet. But you just got to.
Yeah.
Well, for one, there are tricky ways to, for one, that Tesla was a genius mind of the 1900s, right?
Uh-huh.
And now today he's a fucking brand name for a goddamn car battery. It's so insulting to me because, you know, I grew up not knowing who Tesla was. And when I found out, it was like, wait a minute, why didn't anybody ever tell me about this guy? You know, what was the big secret about Nikola Tesla that they didn't want me to know this? And then I started to find other shit, too.
And now that it is the brand name of a vehicle, an electric vehicle or what have you, and that is called the art of distraction or diversion.
Right.
They have diverted you because everybody was talking Tesla, 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 Tesla.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you what, that Elon Musk, what a puke.
I don't know. I don't know the guy, but.
I've listened to some of his interviews, and it's like either he interviews really, really bad, or he's an arrogant puke. One of the two.
Ouch.
That's my personal opinion.
Yeah. People say that about me, though.
I think I personally find him to be an arrogant puke. Or maybe that's he's arrogant and I want to puke. I'm not real sure on that.
Yeah.
It's kind of waffling.
Yeah.
But he comes along with this Tesla electric vehicle.
Yeah.
And so that's how they distract you and they divert you from looking at the original because now they've got you looking at Tesla electric piece of shit vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
So now people are skipping that electric part and they're just going from Tesla to piece of shit. That's how they do that. They are not, you know, we are dumb, but they are not so dumb.
So, so if you ever do hear about Nikola Tesla, you never put it together that where we are.
That he was,
but where
he
we,
was the brains.
Right,
yeah.
And where we are is a product of not capitalism at all. That's got no play in this. What we're living in is just madness with labels. You know, they call it finance, or they call it religion, or they call it a country. All these fancy fucking labels, everything underneath that label is fucked up and garbage. And
it's slavery with benefits.
But at a collective level, if you isolate us a little bit, we're not so bad. But the bigger the group of human carbon-based life forms, whatever the fuck we are, the worse the situation.
Yeah.
All your violence comes out of places where there's a resource people want and the Jews want it, or there's a lot of fucking people and they're all going insane because of all this shit we got being pumped into us. It's not just television, Miss Mary. I mean, think about
it. Oh, I know. And basically, people tend to forget that humans are resources as well.
To a bank, yeah.
Even to corporations. That's why they have HR,
human
resources.
Because that's what we've been labeled. Because we're animals.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're animals to the system. We're not.
Yes.
We're subservient to them, and we accept it, and some of us allow it. Now, I accept it out of duty to, you know, I'm a visitor in a foreign land, but I have my opinion, and so does my wife. But we live under the civilized rules of law that, you know, not the written crap, just the common sense. You know, don't kill anyone, don't steal shit, try to be decent to other people, and there you go. There's not a lot to survival in a small community. It's very simple.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I came from a big city where things weren't this nice. There were a lot of obstacles in my path to where I'm at today.
And yet, for a short guy, you overcame them all and got to where you are.
Oh, yeah. I was never... I had a big brother, a little brother that was bigger than me. So... being short, that did what? And at some age when we were still friendly with each other, people would look at him and then look at me. So they'd ask him, well, what's going to happen? He says, well, he's going to tell me to kick the shit out of you. So I had that kind of protection from all the bigger kids when I was growing up. Yeah. Instead of making my short being a problem, it was like a riding around in a car. Are you kidding me? I was untouchable. I could do as I wanted, and all I had to do was just be nice to people for the most part.
Yeah. See, and I grew up in a big family, and we abused each other regularly.
Yeah.
You know, it was always somebody was always pummeling on you. Why? Because you were there. But if someone outside the family pummeled on you, look out. Because you had a pack of us to contend with then.
My father came from a family like that.
Yeah.
But my mom came from a small family. So between the two of them, it was a very strange home life compared to other kids.
Well, you know, and I thought my home life was really pretty normal until I started going to school. And then even when I started going to school, a lot of the kids that I initially, the first few years that I went to school with, had basically the same background, you know, large Catholic families. Until I went to the junior high that was not a Catholic school. And it was like, oh, wow, holy crap. And a lot of these people, wow. And I'd come home and I'd tell mom, and it does make a darn bit of difference what so-and-so does.
No, but you know what
I make the rules around here.
Do you know what that does? You know what that does do?
What?
Well, I've had people, you know, cross my path in life of different religious persuasions, you know, by having to go to those schools because mommy and daddy made them go. And then when they were old enough to choose for themselves, they went, fuck all that shit. I ain't never doing that again. But I had to, you know, at the time there was no choice. And those people turn out to be very unusual to explain. They play in the game. They have, you know, jobs, and but they don't really follow the rules. But you would look at them and never suspect the real them underneath the appearance.
Oh yeah, yeah, I understand that.
Yeah,
I kind of sort of resemble that.
But, oh yeah, yeah. But
you know, and that whole cathaholic thing.
Ooh,
you know, I was a good little cathaholic girl until mom and dad. Or mom filed for divorce, and then the Catholic Church told me, well, you no longer exist in the eyes of the church because your mom and dad are divorcing. And it was like, holy crap. Okay, so if I no longer exist, well, kiss my ass. You ain't going to see me again.
Oh,
and they didn't.
Yeah. Forever.
So.
And here you are.
The only time I have been to a Catholic church is to go to, like, a family member's Catholic funeral.
Hmm.
And I went to one Catholic wedding, and it was a lot of stand-up, sit-down, kneel, stand-up, sit-down, kneel, stand-up, sit-down, kneel, try not to fall asleep, stand-up, sit-down, kneel. It was like an aerobics class, only with a lot of, and stinky ass.
What?
What is that? Incense, yeah.
Oh,
man,
bad.
That stinky incense. Whew.
Scent.
Stuff I would not burn in my house.
Wow, but it must have had a name.
I have no idea what it is, but whoo, that stuff reeks.
So, but at religious ceremonies, you're supposed to use particulars religiously, right? Meaning you're all unified using. Okay, well, there's your first myth right there. It's like I've tried to explain to my wife. I've made the mistake of seeing a thing on the internet and saying, yeah, I remember having that when I was back in the States. And my Danish wife is going to, well, she likes to cook, so she wants to make something for me. But we're using Danish ingredients, not the stuff that I'm used to. So it's not going to ever be, it'll just be a version of what I want. And I can't get
It'll be a Danish version.
Right. And I can't get that point across that, well, it's going to be similar, but no, because you're at a different altitude on different bit of dirt, and the products that you're putting into it are different than the ones that I had when I had them. Things that were available at those times in my life don't even, they're not even possible anymore. The food chain has been disrupted by, you know, all these big corporations since. So everything's been tampered with.
True. True.
I mean, hell, 60 years doesn't sound like a long time when it's in history, right? But when it's when it's your lifetime and you start out and you got one world, and then in the end of your days, you're looking at this from a distance because I'm not physically in it anymore. But I'm comparing the America I grew up and lived in to the one I read about now, and it's like two different countries.
Oh, sure. It's that slow-boiling frog thing.
Well, as you sit in it, how do you feel about that comment? Because you're in it, so it must seem
different.
It's
a lot different from when I grew up. And yet I still see little snippets every once in a while of basically the lifestyle when I grew up. And a lot of that I see in this little bitty two-blinker that where I live. You know, because there's somebody that's a few blocks away that it's not their kids, it's their grandkids that they're raising. But, man, them youngins run around like the little rascals, just like we did when we were little.
Mm-hmm.
And they're good kids. They're not obnoxious little turds. but, you know, you get to a bigger city, and holy crap, the attitude just kind of, it oozes off of them. I went out to see the grandkids. Well, Farmer and I went out to see the grandkids, and we watched my granddaughter do her cheering stuff, and she didn't get to dance because she was sick the day before, so the dance person didn't put her in the lineup, so she didn't get to dance, but she still did the on-the-sideline cheering stuff. And, you know, watching the basketball games and then having my daughter explain to me that the way they look at it out there, their whole mentality is, well, we have 10 10 spots on the team for basketball. And if you ain't good enough, you know, if you haven't done this and this and this and this and basically done all of the proper steps,
yeah.
you're not, don't even bother trying to be one of those 10.
Yeah.
So, and then they wonder why none of the kids want to come watch. Well, it's because they don't let the kids get engaged in the sport in the first place. They don't even have freaking tryouts for teams. You know, same with football, same with soccer, same with, they have rec centers where all of the kids go and they play on rec teams. And that's where I got to go watch my grandsons play, because they would never be able to play on the junior high or high school team, because that's only for the creme of the creme of the creme. It's like, really? These are kids. They're playing a freaking game. Get your head out of your ass. But
yeah.
it's, you know, it's stupid. And that whole attitude just oozes. It's kind of an uncomfortable feeling.
I do, yeah. I do find myself separate from large groups, even when I'm in the group.
Oh yeah.
Years and years ago, I just knew, you know, some part of my brain just knows that I get what I get from people because I'm vibrating against them, you know. If you're having if you're having discourse, it's usually because you're vibrating on two different frequencies and you shouldn't be around each other in the first fucking place. But
yeah.
society's got a sense of humor and it says, hey, we're going to mix all these fuckers all in one place and see what happens. We got cops. We'll take care of any problems that should arise. Now,
see, and that's where television steps in, because it vibrates at a certain frequency and it gets the bulk of the people to go along and adjust themselves to that frequency.
Ta-da.
And then when someone from the outside steps in and goes, dude, seriously, have you paid attention to that show? I mean, there's a lot of shows that I watch now and I sit there and the storyline may be one thing, and occasionally the storyline I'll get really, really caught up in it.
Yeah.
But for the most part, I watch them to look for the little snafus that they had. Did you notice that he had that on, and then in the next scene he was putting it back on? And it's like, you know, those stupid little things, that's what I look for. Or when they put forth an idea of the government is good for you and these people are radicals and yada, 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 and I think, you guys would be coming after my ass because I identify with the radicals, not you. You know, so
yeah,
now when I was younger and I was watching that stuff and I hadn't done as much digging as I have in the last 10, 15 years.
Or living,
yeah. And learning and unlearning, because unlearning is the hardest thing you will ever, ever, ever do. It's unprogramming yourself.
Good luck with that shit.
You have to be willing to do it in the first place. And there are so many people that are not willing to step out of that comfortable little slavery cage they've accepted.
Mary, look at, maybe it's accept your, you know, you got to accept that something's true before you can find it as a flaw and face it. You know, like me and my what? My, the way I speak is just, drive some people crazy. Just the way,
yeah.
you know, and it's just the way it works. There's so much.
Well, because you're on a different frequency.
Right, but it's so natural for me to do the things that I do, good, bad, or indifferent. They just kind of happen. I don't try to plan shit. When I try to plan something, it never works out. So I gave up. I went, just fuck it. Go with the flow.
I know, that was like when I was doing my solo radio, and it's like, man, you know, I tried to actually plan, you know, and Vinny had tried to tell me, oh, I'll be your producer, and I'll get you all your articles, and I'll do, and it's like, bless your heart, Vinny, but no, because it doesn't work for me.
No, right,
I gotta wing it.
You're
I gotta
more in the moment, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I can understand, but I used to be, and now I'm not, because I'm married. Marriage thing kind of puts a schedule into your life that you didn't plan on.
Oh, yeah, because you have to coordinate with another person. But you two are both on the same frequency as well, or very similar frequencies.
Most of the time, we clash about once or twice a year. I think on an average, if you're going to go for it, maybe once or twice a year we'll disagree. And that'll be that.
Now, see, I think Mercury's in retrograde, or Mars is, or some, because Farmer and I have had some good-natured clashes over the last couple of days, because I'm trying to explain something to him, and it makes total sense to me.
Yeah.
And he's looking at me like, no, no, I'm not, no, wait a minute, here, see this right here? Yeah, I know, but if you just let me.
That, the and they get the best, and the, what they don't count on is the worst of us, too.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's not, so what?
And bless his heart, he puts up with me.
Exactly. Well, you know, that's the whole point of working with other people, right? Somebody has to give and somebody ain't. Because if you both give, then it, whatever you're doing is going to collapse. So somebody's got to stand up and somebody's got to not stand up. And the roles switch depending on whatever the thing is you're disagreeing about. Because all this is, friction, is from two things trying to occupy the same space at the same moment. And I think it works in frequency in when we're speaking, too.
Oh, yeah.
Well, we're not taught these things by schools or anything. You got to come to this by yourself.
Oh, yeah. It's called harmonization.
There you go.
You know, and like you and Soikles, you guys pretty much stay in harmony with each other.
Oh, yeah, for the most part, yeah.
Yeah.
And then
occasionally,
one
of you hits a sour note and the other one goes, hey, wait a minute, that was a sour note. Yeah.
What are you, a fucking American?
And then you go, hey, wait a minute, I meant to do that.
Yeah. Your mother's half Polish. You fucking racist.
I know. And now, I mean, we've just pretty much decided, and it pretty well works. What are you doing? Because then we both start laughing.
I have tried to tell people for a long time that, you know, everything in life isn't fucking pretty. Everything, every fucking second and everything in your life is not going to make you fucking smile. But you can take it too far the other way. There's a balance to all this shit.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Shit, it's like a razor blade. Try walking on that motherfucker and still tell the truth. See, if you not, I'm going to give you the secret to life out there on the radio land airwaves. The secret to life is play the game and be full of shit. There you go.
Ah.
There's your success.
The way to walk on a razor blade is to not have the sharp side up.
Good luck. Yeah, well, it's not like it's in my control, Miss Mary. They got this thing called soul science.
Yeah, well, you know, I knock the razor blade over so I can walk across it. And then if you want to stand that bad boy back up and walk across it, you go right ahead.
Well, I do admire the game for its ability to look you right in the freaking face and tell you a fucking lie. That part of this game is just, it's admirable. Because
it's impressive.
Impressive. And they use things like religion as a tool to gain your trust. And if you looked at religion long enough, you'd find out that, whoops, somebody told a story here.
In fact, a lot of people told a story. When I was 17, it's like, man.
But a lot of people told the story. And some of that story you're not going to ever see because, you know what, they burned the books in the first place. So here we are. We're faced with this dilemma in our mind, and that is this. Somebody is fucking lying out of the two stories. Does it matter which one's not true? No. What matters is that you have the doubt of the truth. You go, wait, somebody lied. Well, wait a minute. That's the word of God. What the fuck's going on here?
And yet, are they really lying? Are they sharing their perspective? Because there really is a difference. There are some people out there that they do not see it as a lie. Yeah. They don't think they're lying. It is their perspective. And they don't realize that if you just take one step off to the side, either direction or frontwards or backwards or however, take one step in a different direction and then look at it, your perspective changes.
Yep.
But by God, their perspective is the only perspective, and damn it, you better look at it from their I can't look at it from your perspective because I'm not standing where you are.
Maybe. Is it possible that certain people in society don't see us as having a perspective to be concerned with.
We have an antisocial perspective, and therefore anti is in front of it, and yeah. So we are, you know, not acceptable.
Well,
we are against the grain.
But it only seems to work in chat rooms. When I'm in real fucking life out there in the real physical Danish world where I don't speak their fucking language, I meet people that are atheists, and musicians, pot smokers, and, you know, travelers, different kinds of crazy people. So the society doesn't control us. You know, if anything, it's kind of gives us a place to gather. So we use the society to benefit us. And the people that pay for it don't seem to mind. They're like, cool.
Yeah. Okay, I'm looking here in the chat, and Grimmy posted something about China unveils stunning community lockdown because of sick people with the whole coronavirus. And I had two grandkids ask me about the coronavirus
yeah.
over the weekend.
Yeah.
And my youngest grandson was really pretty concerned. And I looked at him, and I said, buddy, you know why people are dying? And he said, because they've got the coronavirus. And I said, no, honey. People are dying because they are malnourished. They have been fed junk or crap or don't have enough to eat. They don't have good drinking water. They don't have sanitary conditions to live in. And then you get any kind of bug in, and their immune system is compromised. So those are the ones that are going to go out. And then my granddaughter looked at me and she said, but Grammy, what is coronavirus? And I looked at her and I said, it's the 3-2 flu. And she's not old enough to get that. And a lot of people probably from states other than Kansas won't get that. But, you know, when you called in sick after going out partying the night before, we always said, yeah, they got the 3-2 flu because they were out drinking beer all frickin' night.
Mm.
And in Kansas, they had 3-2 beer and then they had 6-point beer.
Mm. Oh, yeah,
and
I remember that.
So, yeah, so Corona, I said, Corona is the name of a beer. And I think they ought to sue the people that are pushing this coronavirus for copyright infringement and for defamation of character. And she looked at me and I said, 3-2 flu. You drank too much the night before and you feel like shit today. And you'll probably feel like shit tomorrow, too, depending on how much you drank. So both of my grandkids now look at the coronavirus, I hope, as the 3-2 flu. It is something that... it's not going to kill you if you eat properly, if you wash your damn hands and, you know, drink plenty of good, healthy water and eat, you know, eat your healthy food and keep that immune system up. There's so much fear porn out there.
Yeah.
And I just think, my God, people, because one of my daughter said, well, there's been a confirmed case of coronavirus in Kansas. And I went, yeah, in Lawrence, from someone that just flew in from China. But is it really coronavirus? Or are they just putting that out there, suspected case of coronavirus? And there's that selective hearing or reading again. Ooh, suspected goes right out the window. And everybody goes, coronavirus! And I just can't. I can't. I'm vibrating on the frequency that says coronavirus. Yeah, you got the 3-2 flu. Quit drinking so damn much, dumbass.
Well, isn't it coincidental, too, that 5G chatter is all shut down right now?
Mm-hmm.
Haven't seen a...
Because everybody is worried about coronavirus.
Okay, well, I think I've entered into my box. I typed in, does China have 4G? And I found a thing about, they have 4G networks. And I'm just thinking what a coincidence it is because of the reading I've done about 4G. It's not necessarily, it's not tested on us. We don't know. They're experimenting with weapons grade freaking microwave.
Well, 5G is the bad juice one. That's
okay.
In the range that totally.
Look, it's not like saying 3 is safe. I mean, come on. It's still,
well, 3 isn't either, and neither is 4,
it,
technically.
Christ,
but 5G is really...
Right, but I'm just saying, what
it's grade one, yeah.
Every time they go up, we know the one we're using right now is bad for us. So the one four has got to be worse than that. Okay, now, when I was in California, we had a lot of earthquakes. And I lived in California on and off my life quite a few years. And the way they measure an earthquake, every decimal point, 10, doubles the magnitude of the earthquake.
Yeah.
So from 6.0 to 6.1 is actually two times as bad as 6.
Yeah.
Well, your average reader doesn't, you know, that's what I'm saying about all these radio podcasts we do. We're told these obscure concepts by people that claim they have a education or experience in this field. And that's all we ever get told. Then the same people repeat the same shit. And then after a number of years, you start to pay attention and you find out that you're being lied to most of the time about a lot of shit.
But are you really being lied to? And see, this is
here we go with that again, of course.
Yeah, because the people that are telling you that are just passing on what they were told. So they actually believe it to be true.
Why would it matter if they believe it or not?
It's a fine line distinction.
Well, okay, isn't it sad that we have to have the fucking ability to define something is either bullshit or is something is true? I mean, it should just automatically in life, we are human carbon-based life forms. We
yes.
should just be able to fucking live on the truth. But we've got these greedy cunts that want bigger shares than the other rats. And the little rat supports the bigger rat. It's just fucking insane.
And see, I think that's why they don't want us to know our real history, because I think back in the day, like 10,000 years ago or so, there was, or I don't know when, but back in the day before all this bullshit that we're taught now, that the civilization was advanced enough that people didn't have lying and bullshit because they didn't, and it's another thing of why they're not finding writings or a lot of that other stuff, they had no need for it because the communication was all telepathic. You could not lie if you were speaking telepathically to someone. But something happened, whether it was an asteroid, where it was a global flood, whether it was a big-ass ice age that took out a lot of people, and they regressed. And now we are at that stage where we're learning to, but there are leeches that be in this world that do not want us to progress to that point where we can automatically tell bullshit. Now, there's a lot of people like you, you get that gut instinct and you just know whatever's falling out of someone's mouth is bullshit. You just know it. And there's more and more people getting and following and listening to their gut instinct.
Yeah.
They don't want that.
Oh, no,
they
no, no.
They want you to fall for the written word and the bullshit language, because that way you can still be deceived.
Boy,
but
you're,
once
we're
you get to the point where you can tell the bullshit, yeah.
Well, then what? Yeah. Oh, yeah. So you can tell the bullshit from the truth. What difference does it make in the long run is my point.
Well, the difference it makes in the long run is that when you get to the point where you can decipher this stuff automatically, you actually stop listening to the bullshit completely.
Okay.
Because you can tell there's a truth out there, and as soon as it hits you, you know it.
But we're surrounded, okay, from all sides by other people that are for things like forced inoculations on people that don't want it. So, okay, so all government proves to be to me in my mind to this minute is somebody trying to force their will on me when I don't want to go along with it and using this group mob mentality to get their fucking way.
Yeah.
And if I don't go along with it, then they'll punish me either financially or they'll put me in a box with a lock on it. And now here's this really ignorant part of this whole fucking thing. Then they'll physically support me until I die of a natural cause. They can't slow it down or control it.
Yeah.
In a jail
because
cell.
They have to punish you.
Okay.
So you have to stay there and be punished. But while you're being punished, hey, why don't you make those license plates? Hey, why don't you do this? Why, oh, we'll pay you $1 a day.
Right. But do people, okay, but today in this world, do people not understand yet that all these visual problems that we have, we were taught to do them by somebody. This is a plan.
Yeah.
We were supposed to do exactly what we do and have done. Nothing has changed. Nothing's going to change without the consent of whoever controls all the fucking money. And as long as we live like this, and I was reading today, Mike's all in love with the stock market was up for Tesla, and the future is battery power, and all this kind of bullshit. And he takes my my unwillingness to join his fan club for this guy as crying. He must have said that 3 times. Oh, don't stop crying about it. I'm crying about it. I don't agree with you. It's got no emotion attached to it. It's like changing underwear. These things don't smell good. It must be time to change them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's not. It's just like that. It's that fucking important. It's an opinion about something that is nothing more than a distraction for all of us from the truth about these people need to be fucking gathered up and hung. There's no way out of this mess except violence. You either join it and you suffer, or you go against it and you try to kill as many of these fucks as you can on your way out. And that's an insane thing. So, of course, we're going to have organized fucking slavery for the rest of our days. And that's the consensus. That's what people, they stand in fucking line to listen to Trump fucking promise some shit he's never going to do. Where's your fucking wall, suckers?
Actually, a big section of it, from what I understand, blew down the other day.
Well, of course, Trump's building
windy.
It. They're making it out
well,
of cardboard.
No. It's all those goddamn wind generators, I tell you. Damn things are generating wind all over the damn place. Cut it out.
Oh.
It's windy enough already. And then you add politicians to the mix, and that's wind with a noxious aroma to it.
I had an epiphany just the other day walking to the grocery store. Can I interrupt you for this before I forget?
Go right ahead.
It was so weird. We have this health spa thing where people ride bicycles in the window. Okay? You with me so far? Right? They pay.
Uh-huh.
They pay their money to go to this freaking place and ride a fucking bicycle that doesn't go any fucking where.
I know.
And you know how Jewish I am? You know what I thought of?
You thought, go buy a bike.
I thought of hooking those fucking bikes up to some batteries and getting those things charging up some electricity while they're riding them. Charge them to ride the bike, make juice on it, store it in batteries. Yeah, never mind.
Oh yeah, and you know there are places you can buy those. I've seen them.
Well, yeah,
on the internet,
yeah,
so it must be true.
Yeah, it's not that hard to change. Yeah, but it's just the concept of, wait, they're paying you to ride a bike to do fuck all. Why don't you make a little adjustment and add some batteries to this fucking shit? And at least, you know, you're charging them money. That's sweet. But there's so much more. I'm Jewish.
Yeah.
I could find ways to use people that they would go, oh, that felt so good. Because I'm American.
Well,
and, yeah, I learned all these tricks, man.
Why don't you hook up those stationary bicycles to your electric car? And then you could charge the battery in your electric car. And then when you want to go somewhere...
Yeah, it could be like a service. You know, people could work out, and you could park your car behind the place and get a charge.
Yeah.
You know, for a fee off them riding the bikes that they're paying to ride. It's just like never ending profits. This is the Jewish man. This is the Jewish guy's erection. I'm telling you, man. I would be so happy to be rolling around in all that dough. No, I wouldn't. This is an example of what I consider the deceit and what people will do to each other just to fucking make a few dollars. And they will, too.
Oh, yeah.
And
my daughter goes to an exercise place, and I understand why she does.
Because
she, you know, she says, I can exercise. And she does. That girl walks everywhere. And she's I have learned how to kick back and relax.
Yeah, but if you're going to...
But she needs to have a structured, you know, someone needs to tell her, okay, you've done enough of that, now come over and do this.
And
now
we
you've
can
done
make,
enough of that, go over and do this.
We can make producers out of them, too. See,
yeah.
Healthy, and you, look, at you're making electricity. And we're not burning any fucking oil to get, well, yeah, they are, a little bit. Not too much.
Yeah.
Because
you
you're...
know,
it
is kind of funny how that... works sometimes.
This whole thing is just so insane. But I mean, if you're going to waste every fucking move you make and it's going to produce nothing, then wow, that's what TV's for. That was the point I was behind on. It wastes your life. So that
there
you
go. I have a brilliant idea.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you want to watch TV, then you get you one of those stationary bikes and you hook it up to the TV and you can only watch a TV show so long as you keep the RPMs up at a certain level. And once you get tired, you're done watching TV.
Wow. Damn.
See, there you go.
You just killed
that
the late.
That way you'll no longer be a couch potato,
yeah.
But man, you will have freaking ripped legs, let me tell you.
Wow. So you think I'm onto something here? Maybe instead of...
I think you are.
Instead of all this waste and everybody's whining about how everybody's overweight and all this horse shit, and they come up with all this other shit, this diets and crap like that. Hey, you know what'll work? Generate some electricity for some batteries. There you go.
There you go.
For just $9.99 an hour.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. And
yeah.
See, because people that have a few bucks, for one, and that have managed to gain too much weight, whatever they consider that to be, will spend that money to do these things. And gladly spend it as they get a result. And I think we're on something here. You know, the stripper
yeah.
pole thing was a good idea, but, you know, it didn't really work. It wasn't practical.
Well, and there's entirely too many people that did not install stripper poles adequately and crashed through.
Oh,
things.
Yeah, I saw that. Wow.
Yeah.
Brilliant,
so.
Huh? But still, I mean, that's just another example of human beings by nature are freaking curious. Okay, so what you got to do is think of new things to throw at them so you get their curiosity. And then after you've got that, then you have to sell it to groups to get support.
Yeah.
Like politics. This is how things actually work in the real world. You can think of any fucking number of things, but you're only going to get to a certain level of the game according to the family that you're born into. And occasionally they make some, like, Bezos or whatever his name is. They pick somebody for a reason, but they make somebody out of nobody to give you the illusion it's possible. But
yeah.
The reality of it is, who knows this guy? You know, maybe he's an actor pretending to be, you don't know, I don't know. Trump is in the fucking White House fucking things up so bad. It's embarrassing to be American right now.
We went from Ronald Reagan, who played second fiddle to a monkey,
yeah,
to Trump, who was a reality TV king for how many? What were his ratings on his?
I don't know.
Your fired show.
I have no
freaking clue.
I never watched it. But I saw. I see advertisements to watch it when I was watching movies or whatnot. Because
yeah,
I had a long
period
I'd watch movies.
Yeah, we went from someone in the White House that. You know, and the ones in between, they were all just commercials. You know, they were commercial breaks. But you went from Ronnie Reagan, who did movies and played second fiddle to a chimp, and now we've got the reality TV star in there. Everybody else in between was just freaking commercials advertising this or advertising that. That's kind of the way I see it anymore.
Yeah. Well, look at Washington, D.C. to me is like Copenhagen. A group of people a distance away making decisions based on their fucked up information for me. Wow. Yeah. I can find the information that the government and the law is working with to come to their decisions. And if I was drunk enough, I might agree with them. Yeah. But on a good day, if I'm stoned enough and I'm, you know, that right frequency to see that bullshit when I read it, Because sometimes it's disguised. You got to understand, we're reading English, dog Latin. So there's nobody on the planet more confused than an American.
True.
Okay, right. Well, but we're taught that we're superior to everybody because we speak dog Latin. I mean, English. But that's their excuse. That's what they raised me with. That's what we were taught. English number one. Number one in America. Go, go, go. Oh, and hey, Hans, 49ers took a shit. Anyway.
Yeah, the chefs won. Finally, they did not snatch defeat out of the jaws of victory.
What?
Because they are very good at doing that.
What, did the Patriots run out of, murdering faggots that could catch a football? They can't play no more? What?
I don't know. Oh, yeah. Grimner just said, can't forget Jesse Ventura was governor of Minnesota.
That,
I totally forgot about Jesse.
See, there you go.
Yeah.
No.
Talk about WWE. It's all. That's why, you know, when I see a lot of this crap and I see pictures from back in the day when Trumples was hanging out and, you know, donating to this person and donating to that person. And now it's like they're in the wrestling ring. And they're throwing slings and shit at each other, but it afterwards, you know, especially when they're in that close hold and they're getting ready to pile drive or somebody or whatever the hell, then that's when they're saying, so are we still doing dinner tonight? So should I bring red or white wine? You know, that's bullshit.
Yeah. And that's what I mean is we don't know how much of what we're physically seeing and what we're physically reading on the interwebs or any other source. That's true. This could be generated by, you know, words. It's told to you in words, so what gives it any fucking physical reality? Fear or selfishness, maybe. I don't want to die. Give me a fucking shot. Help me, help me. And me, I'm just like, wow. Okay, here we go again, because I've seen this movie before in different versions and different the same program, but with a different product for sale.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like the way they sold it, Obama. You better not say nothing about this nigger or we'll fuck you up.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, and don't you dare call him a nigger because your skin ain't dark enough.
That's all it was about,
what?
Though. You couldn't criticize the guy because of your skin color. Now, this is a fucking fact, period. I lived in it with my own fucking eyes. And you know what I don't miss about America?
Is that nonsense?
The total misery of politics in that country is just consuming. It can suck you up and gobble you up. You don't even exist anymore. You're just a button on the coat of politics. You know, you don't, and if you weren't there, you'd be replaced with another button.
Yeah, but you know what? I'm the button that fell off, and I'm quite comfortable where I'm at.
You were replaced.
The coat kept going.
But you were replaced.
And I'm where I'm at.
Mary, somebody replaced your spot.
Oh, I know. Yeah. I know. And I don't care.
Oh, you
should. I really don't.
You should. I think you should. I'll care for you. How's that?
Okay, you care for me.
Yeah. You know why I care?
Why do you care?
Because there's one more person that will never see the truth because of their selfishness. And I could so easily, in 24 hours from now, change my mind and decide I want to be a greedy fucking slob and go to work.
Well, yeah. And see, that's the thing. A lot of people don't realize everything is a choice.
Yeah.
Everything is a choice.
Yeah. But they make it appear based on your needs, and then they dictate what your needs are to you. And I don't go with that. And I can say, you know, your needs as far as what you're allowed to eat, what you're allowed to drink, what you're allowed to, et cetera. You know, whatever it is, it's got guidelines and fucking government control all over it. Now they want the weed. These pricks won't stop until they got everything. You know, a little bit upset.
And yet the only way they can get everything is if you acquiesce.
Allow them, yeah. Well,
you have to make the choice, whether it's conscious or unconscious, which they prefer unconscious. you have to make the choice to allow it to happen.
But
if
I'm a visitor.
If you don't allow it, you gotta you just look at them and say, excuse me, but there's quite a few more of us that say no than there are of you, one little puny bully that's kicking sand at everybody. We could pile driver you if we wanted to.
Oh, yeah.
But we're not gonna. Yeah. But we are gonna tell you no.
Yeah.
That's really all it takes. Well, just stand up and actually act on that no.
Yeah, I did that on a solo show without you. I was talking about that. According to the numbers that were fed through, you know, the information circus that we live in, there's so many millions and millions of pot smokers. Millions and millions and millions of them. I mean, wow. Look at all the money they generate. Billion in tax revenue. Do you have any freaking idea what something takes to generate $1 billion worth of revenue? It's a lot of fucking money. Okay.
How many zeros is that?
My
mother called the other day.
Nine.
Is it nine for a billion?
Yeah, I think it's nine.
Okay, because mother called the other day.
Six for a million, nine for a billion.
Okay. Because she'd asked about some guy on the Chiefs that was making $40 million a year. And she said, that's just how many zeros is that? And I said, you know, Mom, right now I'm thinking, I don't know how many magic numbers there are behind that four. I'm not connecting right now because it was rather early in the morning and I hadn't finished my first cup of coffee. But it was like, what the hell? Yeah. But then I told her, you know, Mom, he doesn't get to keep all that $40 million because he's got all these Klingons. Those little leaky turds hanging off.
How much does one person need in the... Come on. You know, how many houses can you own? How many countries can you go to?
And you know what's sad is a lot of those people, they supposedly own all of this stuff, but it's all borrowed. You know, they don't actually pay
they're in
out
debt.
For that shit.
Yeah,
they're in debt to their eyeballs.
Yeah.
And then when they're done, you know, producing...
Yeah.
Then they find out that either their agent or their manager or their accountant or their whatever Klingon you want to call that little turd hanging around, they have pretty much robbed them blind. And so they're sitting there with a car that's going to get repossessed and houses that are going to get repossessed. And if they're lucky, they're going to get to keep a little bit of their clothes. And by the way, they're pretty busted up because, well, they play a sport that... You know, it's required to get busted up in that sport at least once.
Yeah.
So, it's sad, you know, and then when you stop and think, people are willing to, number one, pay that kind of money. Someone else is willing to hold out to get that kind of money. And then, you know how they pay that kind of money? They talk other people into going and buying the tickets to go watch these people get injured. Because trust me, I know a lot of people that the only reason they go to football games is to see if someone gets injured.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
The only reason people go to hockey games is to see if a fight breaks out. It's sad.
To you?
To me. But people pay money to go see this.
Yeah.
And then they say they take that money and then they pay these people. It's all... Just a big old circle jerk.
Well, it matters where you are in that social circus chain, you know. Some of us have been born and raised with it, and others of us could take it or leave it. It's not a thing to judge, in my opinion, the love of circus. If you do, you can't help yourself. It's like liking chocolate. How do you tell somebody why you like chocolate? You just do.
Well, and that's part of this whole physicality experience.
Okay.
You know?
And I'm just saying it's more deep-rooted, Mary, than we could ever really define on this talk show. There's more to it than we're capable of knowing. You know, it's a huge, freaking deep-rooted thing, and people want to make it all cut and dry. It's explained by that. No, it ain't. There are so many damn ways you have to possibly go to get to that spot that there's no way to know. And we give things answers that there's no answers to some of this shit.
No.
But we're sold there is through all this crap that other people tell us. Like, life is not an end thing. It's a continuance. Death is the end thing. And then it doesn't matter anymore because you're dead. But why?
Yeah, but death isn't death. Well, I mean, they tell us that death
is... I don't know.
Oh, you're dead
I
now.
I don't know.
We live in an electro... Okay, my personal opinion.
Yeah,
live
me
in
too.
An electrical
yeah.
magnetic...
field.
Universe kind of. That is expressing itself in a physical manner.
With eyes, yeah, but in your eyes.
Yeah.
But your eyes
but
work
that
so
doesn't,
weird.
That doesn't mean that when the physical part stops, that the rest of you stops, but that's what we've been sold.
Yeah,
and
I've
been listening to some different things, and I really have come to think that, you know, when we're dreaming, we're living. It's this other shit that's the dream. And so when the physical body finally says, okay, I'm done. I'm done working. Then we wake up from this dream.
Fine. Maybe. Maybe not.
Maybe not.
But that's what I'm getting at. Is that the roads that are possible, they're misinterpreted because we're told bullshit about them. You know, as a child, I grew up with a lot more freedom because I took it. Not because people thought I was fucking wonderful. Hey, you deserve this. No, I grew up and learned freedom is the last thing in the fucking world you want. Because when you get it, no, it's not what you think. It's
yeah,
not,
you got to be responsible.
No, it's not what we've been sold and pitched it to be. They've taken a word and a concept, and they've misapplied it to an idea that binds you to a group. And that is not freedom.
Yeah.
Freedom is free of that, whatever that is. And most of us...
Yeah, just like all of us anarchists are going to get together, and by golly, we'll show you.
That's
really?
Stupid. Yeah, that's more ignorant than the fucking other side. You know, the side, they don't understand it's a mindset. It's a way to think. It ain't a physical fucking action you take. It's not taking an action as being an anarchist. See? But they've been taught to claim not paying your federal income tax is an action. Well, no, it's not. It's a bullshit story you got conned into believing in something that you feel obligated to do. You promised them you would, and they're going to make you keep your promise. You asked them if you could. You applied to them to allow you to pay income tax. And then you go, hey, what the fuck is this? They said it was a voluntary thing. Well, it is voluntary as soon as you apply. That's what voluntary means. Don't apply, you don't get.
Ah. And then it becomes voluntary at the end of a gun.
Yeah, pretty much. But, you know, everything that the system claims to protect you from is everything they'll do to you. And some people have just got the luck of something, the Irish, with them. And they've never encountered that side of the police where they were just the fucking poor slob that got nailed that time. Because those cops don't care who you are. You're the enemy out there.
And well, yeah.
That's not clear to a lot of people. They think because, you know, they're basically good people, you know, they don't go out there and hurt anyone physically or steal shit, that nothing bad can happen to them from law enforcement. And those days are long gone. Your number just hasn't come up yet.
Yeah.
Well, it may not be you physically. Maybe it's a relative or a close friend. Still there. I mean, when people suffer from injustice, Miss Mary, it's my personal belief that some deep-rooted part of us as human, you know, as life forms, whatever we are, we know when somebody's fucking us and it's not right. But we also know or don't know that we've been conditioned to go along with this crap as since we were little.
Yeah.
And they keep all this confusion going by presenting it in different fashions. Communism, socialism, capitalism, this-ism, that-ism, religionism. It's all just a bunch of fucking cage holders with keys.
Oh, yeah.
And the proof is in the pudding. Mr. Grimner, he'll get on a little rant about that on his show. I heard him talking. Ooh, he was funny. You got to hear Grim Leftovers if you get a chance.
Oh, yeah. I seriously spazzed it off. I totally spazzed. Yesterday was Monday, actually. But
welcome
yeah,
back.
One of those. Yeah. So now it's like, oh, yeah. Okay. Podcast. Mm-hmm. Podcast time. So, yeah, I will definitely listen to the Leftovers podcast.
Well, I'm not forcing you.
Oh, I know.
But
I know.
Would.
But I like to listen to it. And a lot of times, especially in the summertime, you know, when sun's up longer. So I will listen to the podcast while I'm out
working
in the garden.
See, and yeah, that's what I mean. It's about we're being distracted. Yeah, coronavirus. I mean, it's amusing, and I don't mean us because we're older, but the young folk, the people that need to know the truth about shit, they're so fucked up they don't know anything isn't true, and you can't argue with them because that's their truth. So.
Well, you know, and it really doesn't do any good to argue because they aren't going to hear it unless they're ready to hear it.
Well, neither did I. And it took me to places other people wouldn't even consider trying.
Yeah.
Well, I call it fortune. Another guy would go, wow, you didn't have a, you know, stable this and a, you know, a physical job and a career and all that. I said, no, I was having a life.
Yeah. Oh, what was that? It's not the years in your life. It's the
life
in your
years. That's right. And my buddy, my buddy in Florida, John, would say, you live in Lou years. He says, you're so much faster than ever. You do more in a year than some people do in 10. Well, because of the travel, the willingness that I had to travel. You know, I was in, I was in England. And then I went to Arizona, and then from Arizona I went to Mexico, and then back to California, and then had a bug up my ass and decided to go to Miami. And I stopped for a while. But that was my normal, to be stopped for a while and do something, then get up and go.
See, and you like to travel, and when I was younger,
I
did a little bit of traveling, but man, once I had kids, it's like, fuck this shit, you know, and oh God, I remember when I was still at the car dealership, the guy with the 401k stuff was saying, oh, well, you need to invest this, and you need to do that, and you need to do this, and I looked at him, and I said, where's all this money going to come from? That I'm taking out to invest to do this. Oh, but you want to be able to travel when you're retired, don't you?
Oh, fuck no.
No. Uh-uh. And he looked at me and I said, if I go anywhere, it's to stay with family. And it's usually for just a couple of days. And then I'm ready to get the hell out of Dodge because I love you, but I'm going to love you from my house.
Yeah. Cirque and her sister are like that. And she visits here quite a bit. You know, considering that they got to drive.
Yeah.
Cirque's got to go there to work anyway, so she sees her sister a lot. You know, but if they want to, if they want to go do anything, then she's got to stay the night because the trains.
Yeah.
Well, they only run out here so late, and then that's it. Because we're out in I'm telling you, the end of the fucking world. You know?
I understand. I mean, it's minimum of 3 hours for me to go see one of my kids.
Yeah. And that worked against me because I ended up in Denmark. It wasn't so bad in the States. But when I got international and refused to come back, that kind of threw a monkey wrench and shit. But, that's why I think life is like a balancing thing. No, razor's edge. You gotta give something up to get something else. You know, you don't just win at every game you play. That kind of idea.
Well, yeah.
But
yeah.
Then again,
and yet, you know, once you get to the point where you realize you're not very good at that one game or another game, you just stop playing those games. So then you start playing the games that you're good at, and then. You might win like 80% of the time. And you're good with that.
Hmm.
I got a brother like that. Actually, my brother says he doesn't do anything that he's not very good at because he tries whatever he interests him, and if he's not any good at it, then he doesn't do it anymore, doesn't waste his time on it.
That really does make sense. I don't think I've thought about it, but that seems to be my my physical behavior. If I'm not good at it, I ain't going to do that. It's like this thing with the inside growing plants. I had no idea.
Yeah.
But some part of my brain and just knows how to behave with the ant, you know, certain plants. And even in the wintertime, some of them flourish now, and others don't. Because the wintertime, they're not designed to survive. They're out of their element in Denmark.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, and I still try to grow them anyway. So I figure, ooh. What?
Ooh. You want to know something I'm going to try and grow this year?
Sure.
I even have the link up. Mm-hmm. Friend of mine shared this, and I was like, oh, sweet, I'm going to have to do this. You know those loofah sponges?
Yeah.
I never really knew where they came from. But this is the thing, excuse me, that tells you how to grow your own loofah sponge or your own loofahs.
Oh.
Yeah, and it gives you step-by-step instructions.
Wow.
And, you know, it's like, whoa, that's way cool. So I'm going to have to grow my own loofah.
I'm having a deep thought, Miss Mary.
You are?
Mm-hmm. And this might involve some of the brainiacs on the RLM chat that are actually listening to the show this evening. And it's not really a question, but it's kind of a question. And it's going to take somebody with a financial mind to understand the question. Okay? Now, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
You sitting down? Okay.
Yep.
In debt to a corporation that is in debt. What does that mean? Maybe I didn't make it right.
When you're in debt to a corporation that's in debt, what does that mean?
Yeah, to the person that's in debt to the corporation.
So you're robbing Peter to pay Paul, and Peter is sitting there robbing Harvey to pay Peter to pay Paul to pay. It's a big old circle jerk, and you don't want to be the pivot man.
Right, but we do that. That's what finance truly is. It's a circle jerk that we're in debt to somebody that's in debt to somebody that's in debt. It's a three debt chain.
Oh, I'm sure there's more links than that.
Oh, to make it simple, though, for the, you know, come on.
Yeah.
This isn't a brain show.
Oh, I get you.
But, I mean, if I went and tried to loan somebody money and I'm in debt, what am I loaning them?
You're loaning them more debt.
Why? For years we've been doing this shows on and on and on. Why does that one particular little detail never gets any conversation, never gets anybody to do a fucking show about it? How do you justify being in debt to somebody that's in debt to somebody else that's in debt?
I don't know. But you know what? We aren't sold the story that anybody's in debt. It's just the guy on the end that's stuck holding the bag.
Well, all right. The United States.
That's the guy that's in debt.
Denmark is in debt as a corporation to some fucking buddy, the Rothschilds. So, why? This is why I don't understand. Even Cirque just doesn't. She's in it. She lives this stuff and still says to me, they don't get it. It could be so much better, but they're doing everything wrong. And my wife knows that. And she's just a little, 40-year-old woman with a job working for an insurance firm. She's not like a doctor in physics or anything. But a doctor in physics would overlook the simplicity of that statement and not understand it.
See, and that's the problem. Because we have been taught that all of those things, it's just too complicated. You wouldn't understand.
Yeah.
When in actuality, it's very simple. So if you look for the simplest explanation, odds are that's the one you need to go with.
Well, yeah, I go with simple if I can. That's why I'm so anti-round globe and anti-gravity, all this crap. Not that these things don't exist. let's not be completely ignorant, but that they're not defined in the expertise that you're told they are. These people are guessing. And if they're not guessing, they're reading the guesswork of the predecessors. They're not coming up with any fucking proof of fucking anything. Just feeding us more stories about, this guy knew what he was talking about. Look what George Washington accomplished in 17... Da, 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 da. Yeah, well, look what George Bush is doing today. Was yeah. My thing. And they, No. That's we're here to talk about the old guy. See?
He's an old guy, too.
But
the other old guy, the old dead guy.
So is history yet just another television distraction for us to be controlled by the very people that sell us about how free we are?
Well, that's
free to do what?
Story. They took one of those S's out.
Have you ever sat and thought down, what are these free things that we're all inclined? Freedom is so enticing that we want to be free to do these things. What are these things that you need to be free to do them? What in the fuck is it?
I am free to go pay for a license fee. Hmm. They took the R out. That's the only difference. I'm free to pay a license fee so I can do what I would normally do anyway. But I am in a free country, so I have to pay a fee to be free.
And like here, the slaves are cool with it because their life is comfortable. So what the fuck do they care?
Yeah.
Only a poor man complains about the prices. See?
Oh, what's that one? Yeah, if you have to ask the price,
you can't
afford
it. Yeah.
Yeah.
No. That's, it's like buying a house. How much? Well, there you go. Get the bankers. We got another fucker. I was a salesman. You're listening for certain words, certain signs. You're looking for beads of sweat.
Yeah.
You got your prey right there. All you got to do is claw them. They're not running anywhere. They're going to stand right there. They're going to sit down and they're going to sign the document for you. And you're going to get a commission from their money.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, I've done this work, so I feel terrible about it at this point in life. I wish I would have done some other productive thing, but I didn't. I was Jewish or whatever, and I found selling products was more profitable than work, labor works, or school. Good God. Go to college and get out of there after 4 years to make, $10 an hour? Are you out of your fucking mind? I can make twice that working for somebody else, doing a physical labor job.
Mm-hmm.
And this is years ago when I was young, and people would turn their nose up at me, but I always had my own. You know, I wasn't the type to come in needy for anything. And it made up people kind of pissed off because they didn't rent places to live and shit like that. Well, can you get a pocket full of money, but you don't live anywhere? What are you, some kind of burglar? Shit like that, you know. Anyway, it was a fun time in life. When I was younger, I did things in a unique way, and it made people very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Because their input, their training through television was to identify the things they didn't know and compare it to a TV show or a news they saw. Oh, I saw a guy there. Looks just like you on the TV. You are you're a hippie. You know, and if I cut my hair and wear a suit, oh, I saw a guy on TV. It looks just like you. You know what he was? He was a salesman. See, so there's a suit for every character that you want to play. All you got to do is wear the right suit. You can play the game.
Oh, yeah.
It's that simple.
Put the proper costume on.
It's all. Look at the fucking people that they have in positions of power. Joe Biden, I wouldn't let Joe Biden near my female relatives without a fucking weapon. That motherfucker is greasy. God. And they're promoting it like it's a good thing. He's on there slobbering on his granddaughter. Like a fucking, I don't know what to explain it as. It just didn't look as innocent as it should. It looked weird. I was insulted. And I got daughters. So, you know, there's just some things that, you know, as a man, you look the way I was raised about, I guess, I look at females and think, wow, you don't do that with your granddaughter. That's inappropriate. But society has been changed into this, you know, anything goes kind of, you know, if you want to wear a jock strap down Main Street and, you know, pick your ass, go for it. Nobody's got a right to stop you from being you, baby. So they're just unleashing all the fucking one-of-a-kinds on the many. And they're going, well, they've got rights. You've got rights. So do they. I don't want those rights.
That's where freedom of speech morphed into freedom of expression, because there's all kinds of things that you can say you are expressing yourself. And, yeah, I have read the Constitution, and it does not say freedom of expression. It says freedom of speech.
Hmm. Ah, and that's why I complain about English for. Because it's so ambiguous that you can make something out of something that it wasn't intentionally to be.
Yeah.
And with the proper education from the public school system, you'll argue tooth and nail about something that you're completely wrong about because you've learned that at school and they told you that. So you're going to be loyal to your knowledge. Getting beyond that's not easy. I did it. And I take the risk of being looked at as kind of stupid sometimes by other people. But you know what? I don't really care because I can't no more prove my story than you can. So we're just arguing about nothing. This is nonsense.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, me and you, me and Hans, me and Vinny, whoever I'm arguing, me and Circle, whenever that friction is there, it's because two things are trying to occupy the same spot at the same exact moment, and we're not built to handle it. So we collide, and it's just the way we are. And they can't take that away from us. They can take every fucking thing else out, but they're never going to take that friction that is, you know, nature given, because people are people. You know, and when you over-define and you make laws about every little fucking thing, you create bigger problems. Instead of teaching us from a decent age, you know, young age, how to behave. Now they're going to teach these little five-year-olds, you know, what to do with their dick. This is what I'm reading. Instead of grow up and, you know, become a nice person and be kind to animals. Hey, go fuck little Mary over there. What?
No, thank you.
But I'm just, this is, I'm sorry I used your name. I didn't realize that.
I know, that's okay.
But the point is, to me, my outdated, I'm an old guy, I think children should be allowed to be children, that the world is just fucking everybody up. Everybody. Except the old people, because we've been through it. We survived what, you know, the modern day version of what they tried on us that didn't work. They've perfected it. Now look at the product you get.
Yeah.
And the older people that are fucking supporting Trump are just living proof that nobody has a fucking brain anymore. People are living on emotion. Donald Trump didn't win the fucking election in the first fucking place. There's your number one flaw to this whole Trump trauma thing. Hillary did. And, well, the Electoral College decided that, no, she didn't. So, where is your fucking voting worth a fuck? If voting worked, Hillary would be in charge and you guys would all be sniffling. See, but voting didn't work. So making fun of us for not voting, what did that change? Not enough people voted for Trump. He still got the job.
Mm.
What? Yeah. This is not my opinion, Mary. This is on the record.
I know.
But you know how much shit I've listened to over the last 3 years about how fucking wonderful Trump is from people that never heard of the motherfucker before he became the president.
Oh, did they really never hear of him?
No, yeah, no. They don't know about the uncle that took Tesla's papers. They only know this.
Oh, well, there's an awful lot of people that don't know that.
That's what I'm talking about, the important shit that you need to fucking know about a man to vote for him to be in the White House was denied the public. And even if they were given that shit, they wouldn't understand it.
True.
So the Electoral College decided that the modern-day mind was not going to get Hillary Trump. or Hillary Clinton. They're going to get Trump instead. Well, to me, he supported her.
Yeah.
He supported her politics in New York for fucking 20 fucking years. I saw it. I lived in New York in 86. So from looking at cities that I lived in and politicians, boy, what a fucking mess we're in. And from one city to the next, it's the same crap. Just a different dialect of the crap you just left somewhere else.
See, and I don't even see that stuff anymore. Unless I'm right there in the middle of it, I just don't even see it. And I wonder if maybe that's just because I just don't see it. You know, there's an awful, I used to see an awful lot of that crap on Twitter, and I used to see an awful lot of other stuff on Twitter. I don't see it anymore.
Oh, yeah, because you're immune to it now. You're done to it or what? You put it out?
Well, I don't know if I've just shifted enough to where I just flat-ass don't see it. It's no longer in my spectrum.
Well, that's how fast your brain works, is I think your brain's working so quick, you're making that decision to not look at it. As you look at it, that's how complex I think we truly are. I've seen books about the eye because I got bad eyes. I wanted to know why I got bad eyes. So I thought, well, I'll start by looking at how the eye works. And I could not for the world. I could read the information, but I couldn't process it in a sensible fashion to understand it. Your optic nerve sees the world upside down and da 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 goes, oh, fuck you. I'm done.
Mm-hmm. Did you know that lemongrass oil is a good nutrient for your eyes? You don't ever want to put it in your eyes. You want to put it like cheekbones and up around to the brow.
No, I didn't know that.
Well, I just found that out not too long ago because I thought I'm just going to look this up and see.
Saffron, Saffron tablets claim to improve your eye vision in 90 days if you take 20 milligram saffron tablets a day for 3 months.
It's probably high in resveratrol, which is a chemical that is good for the eye.
Well, you're so smart. You're like a brain guy when it comes to this stuff. This is your area.
Some of it is.
Well,
it's what fascinates me is where I know, you know, about some of this stuff. But, and, you know, from eye doctors. And so then I researched and. Mm-hmm. And all that other fun shit, but yeah.
You know what? Research, they leave a part of this out too, Miss Mary, is that you need to discard the bullshit. You have to have a bullshitometer when you are researching or investigating a concept. Otherwise, you're going to just believe the first fucking thing you read.
Yeah.
Don't do that. Read a couple of things. And then I recommend what I do. I would recommend to anybody, but they can do it. Is go with what made your dick hard the first time you read it. You know, if you didn't like what you read, don't force yourself to accept something that deep down inside you mentally you know you're rejecting it. Then go against it.
See, and that's the switch that I think they have tried to keep shut off. But more and more people, that switch is starting to turn on in.
Yeah.
You know, the bullshit-o-meter.
Yeah, it's like, I don't want Mike to think that I take that chatter back and forth banter. That's just playing around. We disagree about something. It's got nothing personal to it. But he thinks that it does, but I don't. I just think it's another government business fucking scam on the public because they control our choices. Through lying and manipulation, and they always have. They've never told us the truth.
Speaking about that, I wonder what the gun sales are like in Virginia right now.
I don't know.
Because I would lay dollars to dog turds that there's an awful lot of people that purchased firearms of one kind or purchased ammunition, and the firearms manufacturers and the ammunition manufacturers are going all the way to the bank with that stuff. Mm-hmm. So how many of those politicians own excessive amounts of stock in firearms
and ammunition
and ammunition companies?
See,
and so
that's
they play
what,
along with this game and put this bullshit out there
yeah.
so that they can increase their profit margin.
Yeah. And then make all the threats just like they're supposed to. And the National Guard's going to shoot you, and we'll do a few red flag laws coast to coast to make you really believe it. We'll take a few suckers out just so that...
Because nothing loosens people's grip on their money faster than fear porn.
Yeah. And they've done, and it's coming at us from climate change, coronavirus, this, that, the every possible thing. They got you chasing your ass. Now me, I'm too old and lazy to chase anything anymore, my friend. I ain't done chasing. So now I just sit on my butt.
There you go. Oh, hey, Rob Work said that his CBD oil has resveratrol in it, which is cool.
Oh, and I believe Grim said that he'll keep your link in my notes so that, you know, people can always be, you know, have it shoved in their face that you're there. And
there
I bet, and I'm telling you, just because of my personal experience with Rob on the internet and the talking of a few times on the radio, he's got my trust. He's not hiding from anybody or hurting anybody. He's telling you the truth. And that's the kind of people that, like you, Miss Mary, or Grimnir, or anybody else that I spend any amount of time, you know, blathering with. Beetle. He's a wacky guy to chat with, but it's fun. You know, we're just bantering, having a giggle in the morning, having some coffee. Stuff like that. That makes
just interactions.
Yeah. Yep. And some people, I can't get along with them. Everything's too serious. So, you know, the world goes around that way. You can't worry about it too much, but you can't avoid it either. Like, I fuck around about the Iggy option. I said I got half the room on Iggy already. I'm running out of people to talk to.
Yeah, you are.
Because I'm fussy about my input. You know, I don't want your shit in my living room. Maybe Vinny's shit sometimes, but...
So long as he cleans it up.
But he don't. Man,
don't ever clean up someone else's shit. That's just disgusting.
That boy was in detail about his weekend at the spa on the internet chat site. And some of it was a bit graphic. I mean, I don't know. But freedom of speech being what it is, I'm not complaining.
Well,
I'm just saying.
And mental clutches. Some people just don't have a working mental clutch.
Well, yeah, that too. Or then there's the other side of it is he got his ass saved from a very, you know, deadly illness. So he's in la-la land right now.
Yeah.
When the healing starts, let's see if his spirits stay up, because it's hard that first week or two when you're, you know, starting to walk and shit. Oh, everything's healing. That's what healing is all those muscles tightening and shit getting hard down there, little brain, little cells making scabs. That's some painful shit.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I know you know. You've got children, so you know more than I know. I'm not trying to take your pain crying away from. But I had hernias, and even that probably doesn't compare, but they were painful. Ooh. You know, too, at the end, before I got them fixed, riding in a car was over a bump was like, would make me cry like a little girl. Just that sensitive to abrupt motion from being damaged.
Labor pains did that to me.
See? Right. And as cruel and painful as I thought it was, I still have my hats off to the woman that dropped my kid. It's like, wow.
Yeah.
No, thank you. I take the hernias again instead of trying that.
I understand.
Well,
I understand.
I'm just saying, as a guy, I don't know. I can only assume from looking on and her almost crushing my hand when she delivered the kid. But that was another story.
Yep. See, and my sister said that actually passing kidney stones is more painful.
Okay, now I've read shit on theminds.com. I don't know if they're memes or not about. Now, medical science claims that men can have children. So I figured it was just somebody fucking around making a meme. But if there's any truth to this shit, because God, what don't we know how to do? We'd sure know how to make up a story and make it look believable. Remember when we were all going to have sex robots that talked like Michelle Pfeiffer and looked like Marilyn Monroe? That was that.
No, I don't, because I didn't want one of those.
Well, right, but
so
they
I
had
pay attention.
They had, but there was. Oh, come on! You don't have to pay attention to not notice the links. Come on. All right, so you didn't notice. I noticed, maybe because I was a guy at the time when I looked. I don't know. But there was a big shitload of this stuff, and then it dies, right? And then the next thing comes along, and it's like people just jump from one thing to the next thing.
Yeah.
And then there's a few people that are, they have a message. And it, like there's a guy on Mindset's always posting about vaccines and the information he gets about that. Mm-hmm. And it's all in a negative light to vaccines, so I always repost shit. It's really good stuff. But then there's other people that just they get stuck in a rut about one thing, and it's not interesting to me. So, see?
Yeah.
It's, but I'm telling you, this being a cult leader is not everything you guys think it might be.
I know. It, it's not always good to be the king.
It has
I get that.
It has a very dark side. Because trying to get you much to do what you're told sometimes ain't as easy as it looks.
Well, and then you've got to start worrying about the guys that want to take over your spot. You know, be the leader of the cult.
Well, that's why that's why you hire somebody like Donald Trump to pretend to be the leader of the cult so that you can actually be the leader of the cult. Nobody knows you're the leader. They think it's Donald Trump. They go, oh, look, Donald said so. I saw it on Twitter. Yeah, well, that's exactly what Mr. Rothschild told him to say. you just don't know that because, well, you're limited in your input. Limited input is your enemy. Got to hear the enemy's side to judge whether or not there is an enemy or not. Just taking somebody's word for it's stupid. Like this Islam thing. What a crock of shit. This is, we're fighting Israel's enemies for them under a lie. It's really, that's what I call, that's religious.
The whole war on terror thing.
It's religious abuse.
How are you going to have a war on terror? Because terror is an emotion. It's an emotional reaction.
Well, my
problem. So how do you have a war on that? And that's that whole critical thinking, that whole logical thing that a lot of people just, they just hear, it's a war on terror. How are you going to conduct a war on a emotional reaction?
Well, first off, you get rid of Israel and stops all this shit. Because what they did was that to create all this shit we're dealing with now, they put the Jews right in the middle of the freaking Arabs. And then they gave them choice property, too, to choose from.
Oh, yeah.
Now,
they did that on purpose.
Okay, right. And they're expanding instead of the minuscule little Jews that they're supposed to be. How come they're doing all the expanding? They're surrounded by their fucking enemies, but their enemies don't seem to fight them back.
Because it's that whole minority thing, you know, they're the minority and you're not supposed to pick on the minority. But the other thing that people don't realize is one person is a minority in almost every group. One person
a minority. You didn't mention the American forces that are based in those countries.
I know. How dare those countries have their crazy ass ideas
and then
around
whose side
that we put there
okay.
on purpose to
and
keep
no,
them from, yeah.
But no matter what Israel does, whose side are the Americans on every fucking time?
I know.
And it doesn't matter what Arab nation you talk about, Palestine, Saudi Arabia, they like those guys. That's weird. But you go into Syria, and all of a sudden, what do you got? More fucking Arabs. They're a problem. Well, how come the Jews aren't a problem? The Jews are invading the Arabs, but the Jews aren't the problem. The Arabs are the problem. I don't get that.
You know, I have a brother that actually told me that there is no such thing as Palestine, and the Palestinians have no homeland. And I went,
wow, they took that, renamed it Israel, and wow, fuck. Whoa, okay. I don't know.
Yeah.
What can you say, Mary? People, see, that's what I mean. People are only going to react to the things they allow to make up their mind. what information would make his mind up would have to be religious. There's no other way to look in this situation and not just see it's a bully using America to fuck everybody around him.
Well, let's see, if you look at it from the religious aspect, the Bible does not say that Palestine. But, dude, seriously, you're basing your whole reality on a book that was supposedly written a couple thousand years ago. Look at how the geography has changed just in the last 50 years.
And you're really good with all this stuff with me. I appreciate it, Miss Mary. Because you know why? We have come to the end of another In a Perfect World podcast. And it's just about it's just about that magic time to call it a day in puppy land. So do you wanna do the usual stuff, or do you want me to do you go ahead. You haven't been here.
Oh, the schedule
the
stuff?
And what how you end the show however it makes you happy to end it. There's a recording for that reason. In the link, you will find a schedule if you so desire a schedule. We just like to always talk about it, so it's fun. But it's getting bigger now. It's getting too big. It's like
Is
too
it really?
Big
well,
to manage. He's got a show on every day now. Every day is filled with got somebody. And on some days, there's more shows than other days. There you go. And it's all on the schedule if you open it up and look.
Well, and that's what I'm trying to do.
Hey, see how
I'm
smart.
I'm looking for it. There it is.
Pop-up schedule.
I found it now.
Grim made
I
that.
I found it.
He made that page so easy to operate. Even I can do it.
I know. It's scary, isn't it?
Yeah, because I'm looking for the difficult shit, and there isn't any.
So, let's see. Tomorrow at noon Eastern Time is the Age of Fission with Lonnie Clark. And then Thursday, I don't see anything on Thursday on the
Power Hour. So Thursday night.
There it is, way down there at 11 p.m. Eastern Time. That's why I didn't see it, because it's down below the Ocelli Effect. That's why. Because the Ocelli Effect is on Channel 14 Monday through Friday. So, yeah, Chuck Ocelli. Sweet.
Tonight's right after us, I believe.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
So the Power Hour is on Thursday at 11 p.m. Eastern Time with Prince, Z-Pix, and Rotten Sox. Then on Friday, Vinny is currently on hiatus. And then we have Freaker's Ball Friday evening at 11 p.m. Eastern Time. Saturday at 2 p.m. Eastern Time is the Dork Table with yours truly and Slasher. Sunday we got the with Grimner at noon Eastern Time and a rousing game of trivia for our trivial minds in the RLM chat. And directly following that is Hal Anthony, who's going to open up a can of whoop-ass on yo' ass behind the woodshed. So, yeah, all kind of cool stuff coming up here on the RLM. And also, I just want to put this out there so y'all know, stop and think. Whenever you reminisce, whenever you look at what happened 5 minutes ago or 5 days ago or 5 years ago, if your memory works that far back, everything that has happened has led to this moment right here and right now. So when you really get that concept of that, that all of the, even in the whole world, even things that you don't even know about, every single thing that has happened has led to this moment right here, right now.
Love it or leave it. Yeah.
That's right.
And that
That's right. And if you don't like your here and now, do something to change it.
Ta-da. And just not every waking moment is a party. There you go. Live with
That's
it.
That's right.
Learn
That's
to
right.
balance the fucking wave.
That's true.
Wow. Thanks so much, too. To you, because I do this stuff alone sometimes, but I really prefer it when I got somebody to yak at and interrupt. Well,
you are very good at interrupting, but I'm getting better at it as well.
I know, but maybe not better at more. You just tolerate it. I'm not dumb, but okay, maybe a little bit. But anyhow, thanks a lot for helping me out on In a Perfect World this week. And we'll see you Saturday, or Next Tuesday, you won't be here. So next Tuesday, I got a solo. And I'll make it a point of saying it on the show now so if they hear it, they can do something about it. If somebody wants to join me next Tuesday, let me know. And we'll make arrangements to put you on with me on next Tuesday in Mary's stead.
Sweet.
Thanks a lot for listening, everybody out there in Radio Land. Anything else?
Thank you, guys. Nope. Just got to say, see you, love you. Bye-bye.